Hello, everyone. Nurgle has blessed me. Let's try it again. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Blood Bowl Sundays. I changed my mind. Just ending this off with three random games feels a little weird, especially since we're now just getting into the top tier teams. So you know what? We'll do this one. We'll finish out this league that we're currently going through and the next league that we will be going through. And then we'll call it good. We'll retire the Boar Boys and we'll wait for next season to see exactly what's going on. Hopefully there will be a lot of repeats, so that way I can actually explain how next season's going to work. Okay, Nurgle, anytime you want to stop, that'll be fine. If I remember correctly, we're actually on the last match for the Boar Boys in this particular field. Ah, yes! Anyone that has played Total War Warhammer will know why I'm finding this very hilarious right now, but the orcs and the dwarves tend to butt heads a lot in fantasy, and you know, not play very fair with each other, and it looks like this is just gonna be a straight-up beatdown game. Huh. I'm good with that. No inducement. And we're pretty close to the same team value, so we should be having a lot of fun. And, they are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ow! The dwarf giants are more popular than us. They have a higher team value, and they're all around just a better team, except we have more rerolls. Sorry, I just blanked there for a second. In my shame of being not as good as my opponent. It's been a while since that happened. But anyway, to describe the dwarf team, the dwarves. Specifically what I mean by that is they're short and they're hard to take down. Most of them, if I remember correctly, have the thick skull special rule, which means that they're really hard to knock out. They have pretty low movement and average strength. Low agility, but they have really high armor. We're talking like 9 on everybody, and that's just kind of annoying to deal with at points. And since you need a 9 to send them off the field, yeah, no thanks. And because it's still winter, I'm still going to complain about the fact I'm playing in the snow. And yes, I don't actually know if the dwarves have women. I would assume the dwarves have women. But as you can plainly see, the dwarven cheerleaders are drunk dwarves. I can get behind that. And the Bugman's Brew, XXXXXX, surprised there's not 9 of those, is the official drinking beer of Blood Bowl. It's also, I believe, what the either competitor or the actual producer of Bloodweiser. Bloodweiser being, you know, the thing we use in order to wake up our guys slightly faster. So, these are dwarves. So strong blitz would probably be good. And I'm kicking off because of course I am. And the names and tackle zones have been changed to protect the innocent. The innocent that will probably get slain during this match. Cheering fans! Thank you, my wonderful audience. Well, half of you, and half of you, how dare you betray me! Where'd the ball go? Oh, it landed straight on the guy. But yes, let's see. Dwarven blockers are basically the standard unit, and they come with block, tackle, and thick skull. They're hard to take down. Dwarven blitzers are a little harder, more or less. And oh no. forgot about that. Okay, we just got through fighting a goblin team. So, just to remind everybody, that's a thing. And yeah, it's kind of hard to dodge around a dwarf team. Troll Slayers are more or less the equivalent of... Well, I don't want to say the equivalent of a blitzer, because that's not really 100% true. They're just basically stronger blitzers. The guys that the trolls, or the dwarves send in to take out the trolls. The big guys. The guys with 5 strength. Because Dauntless is amazing. Dauntless allows you to basically match your opponent's strength, I believe. Yeah. Roll a d6 to add, roll a d6 and add it to the strength stat. So basically, you have a pretty decent chance of going up against somebody stronger than you and smacking them in the teeth. Runners are basically your ball carriers, and then there's this asshole. Ugh. Okay, so I mentioned how in Blood Bowl you can kind of get away with a lot of stuff you couldn't in real life. This is one of those instances. The dwarves brought a steamroller. An actual frickin' steamroller. Now, granted, it is a secret weapon, so once they score, or I score, it'll be off the pitch, but it's gonna be bothering the ever-loving crap out of me for a good long while. Oh, and I believe Dauntless only counts against your blitz. Or specifically, your blocks. But yes, as you can see, these guys are decked out pretty much everything. The lowest armor they have is 8. Ugh. So we're gonna go ahead and make their lives an absolute living hell. Thankfully, most of their agility is 2, so it should be fairly easy for us to just run straight over them, hopefully. And this is actually a team we can outrun, which is just fantastic. But before I get too wrapped up in my own nostalgia, I am going to say that the dwarf team is a tier 1 team, just like we are, so it should be not exactly easy for this game, though... If I had to pick a tier 1 team that was probably the hardest to play, it would probably be these guys. If for no other reason than, well, that movement and that 2 agility is really, really hard to get around. Ha! You thought you could take out Roy. And you are mostly correct in that stance. Or at least the... the death roller. I should have been paying more attention to that. Granted, it has 4 movements, so it's not exactly going to be easy to take care of, but it should be easier than we're currently doing. We're going to go ahead and knock you over to the side, and oh, Gulluk managed to hurt the Troll Slayer. Now, should I move the troll away from him? Yes, but I don't have break tackle, so I'm not even going to remotely try that as for right now. 2 dice, 1 dice. You get 2 dice? No, you don't get 2 dice. Tarfang, of course, does not get 2 dice. Yeah, we'll go ahead and move up. Thank God we're fighting... dwarves now that we've actually had some upgrades. Because this is one of those teams that you never want to fight early, if only because it becomes a pain in the ass to fight these guys. Yeah, I saw that coming, but there was not a whole lot I could do about it. And look at the little stunty legs with their giant beards. You know, I'm halfway tempted to let him score just to get the death roller off the field. That's actually not a horrible plan. Not a great plan, but it's not a horrible one. And they left that guy basically completely open. And this is why most of the dwarves have thick skull, because you're gonna be doing that a whole hell of a lot. Gullock, be a deer. Gore thrust. Oh no, you don't have break tackles, so I'm just gonna let you do whatever you want to do, and hope to God that I can stop you. And Tarfang? Oh, Valman's gonna stand up if I move. Fine. Oh, that's not a good idea. No, stop. I want you to move there. It's not a great position, but it's better than the one you're currently in, so. Wait, why are you blitzing? Are you blitzing? No, I... Oh, come on! He actually has break tackle? Well, that's gonna piss me off. Which means Gorthrust should not move. Oh, that being said, we can have a Black Orc Blitz. That might actually be entertaining. Oh, come on, let me hit something. The more I play these, the more I realize I'm not going to be able to play anything else other than something that hits something. Mohawk. Annihilate his ass. I want to use Dump Off, the bastard! I'm swearing a lot in this video. I don't mean to. I'm just very, very angry. One dice frickin' everywhere. Okay. Fine game. I don't want to get up because he's got all that nonsense, but I kind of have to. Alright, well let's try and get next to the guy with the ball. Thank God most of my team has block right now, otherwise I would be in a lot bigger mess than I currently am. As long as Grabball stays at that backfield, I'll have at least one good blitz.